at it as an industrial ecologist would. So now we're going to get to the participation part, okay? What waste, let's take this room that we're sitting in, or industrial, maybe mine and sweet pair will participate too. What waste do you think is created here in this establishment?
The question is for you, Martha.
No, we don't want to bother her. She's
working here.
I have all this question.
What is some of the waste that you have, that you have to throw? What do you have to sort of throw away? What?
Pastry.
So food. Remember when someone said food?
Coffee grounds.
Coffee grounds would be thrown away.
Yeah. And in fact, if anybody knows, because I saw it at some other cafe where they save the coffee grounds and give it to farmers.
Yes, right.
So I'd like to do that.
Okay. Yeah. What about, there must be a lot of paper and plastic products that you have to throw away. Although we do have coffee mugs here that are washable, so that's good.
Yeah, I mean, to go with paper, plastic.
There's packaging, a lot of your stuff comes in packages.
Yeah, all cardboard boxes have to be broken down.
Once in a while, a chair might break and you might have to throw that away. Or a window breaks.
Plus we have grease.
Grease, yes, that's another one that they have. Okay, so grease is, okay, so.
$500 grease trap we had to install.
Right. How about this? Here's one you might not have thought of. Heat. They throw a lot of heat. This place has to be kept warm so that we're all comfortable. But there's a little bit of heat that's leaking out the windows. There's some that's going in the vents. Restaurants only are comfortable if there's enough air circulating so that you're not smelling all the grease when we're sitting here. When that air circulates, it's usually air from the outside in, has to be heated out, and then it goes up and back out. So they're constantly basically throwing heat out into the cold air, or they're using air conditioning. So you can see how we can start identifying all the waste streams. Okay, does somebody, Martha started talking about how industrial ecologists would think. So she came up with an answer for coffee grounds. Did everybody hear what she said about coffee grounds? And she could start doing that with food waste. She could store it in some sort of bin. And she could maybe have a farmer, their farms in Brantford, or their gardeners that compost still. They could come by once a day, pick up her compost, put it into a compost bin, and that becomes soil for either a farm or somebody's roadside or somebody's tree. Okay? So that's what industrial ecologists do. That's the game they play, is how can we eliminate this word waste from our vocabulary? So there's, yes, good. Recycling is good. What are the other R words? What's another R word you can do?
Reuse.
Reuse, right. Okay, so how would reuse work? Let's think of an example.
Plastic bags.
Okay. So let's take this cup here. Let's say you wanted to reuse it. Can you think of some ways that you would reuse it?
Wash it out and use it for a cup later on.
Okay, so that's true. If this young man took the cup home and he washed it out and his mom and dad thought it was clean enough, he could maybe have it by the sink, and if he needed to drink water in the middle of the night, he could use that cup to eventually decay. And that would be a reuse example. You could save, everybody in the school could save cups, and maybe the science teacher could use them, and or the garden club could use them, and everybody could plant little plants in them in the spring, and then all the kids could take little tomato plants home, and then they would be thrown out. So every time you use something one more time, that's reuse. This is a good example here of not creating waste. Now, someone might say, here's a typical industrial ecology question, and this is going to get us to the last major point I want to make, and then we have some discussion. What do you think is better for the environment, using this cup? Now, if someone had to make this cup, and then this cup has to be washed and kept up to public health standards every time it's washed. I don't want to be drinking this if I'm going to get the germs from the previous drinker. So it had to go through very hot water, soapy water, had to dry, versus this cup, the cardboard cup, which comes out of a plastic sleeve, totally clean, it's used once and then thrown away. Which do you think is better for the environment? This one. Why?
It doesn't fill the landfills. I mean, you use energy to heat everything, but you're going to do
so,
that.
Right,
and the landfills full of stuff that's going to take forever.
Okay, so how would you, so you're making a decision that Actually, this wouldn't go to landfills, it'd go to the incinerator.
I'm sorry, incinerator.
Yes, and in Branford, we incinerate everything. Used to be, we landfill everything, and that had huge political problems in Branford, which we're still living with, as you know. So, there's a, and you mentioned energy to make the cup, and I mentioned water has to be used to wash here. So, how would you go about thinking, which would, both of them potentially have environmental impacts? Like heating up the water is going to use energy. The water's got to go somewhere. It's going to go to our sewage treatment plant, which is a little bit full right now. The soap that's going to be used to wash the water, that's going to go to the sewage treatment plant. Okay, so I can start making this look. And then, what about how this was made? You know, this is clay, had to be dug out of the ground. You had to fire it. You have to paint it with dyes that might be toxic. Okay, so there's a, industrial ecologists have come up with a method, or at least a term that I want to teach you now, called life cycle analysis. Who wants to guess what life cycle analysis is? Ooh, good. Yes.
How a product starts off before it gets made and then it gets shipped out and then used and then thrown away.
Perfect. I'm ready to give you a PhD. Okay, so life cycle is something you sort of can understand, sort of from cradle to grave. So when you, when sometimes when we like use like this cup, we tend to think of what's going on right now. But you can see, looking back in the past, this cup came from somewhere. The owners here had to buy it at a store. The store had to buy it from a manufacturer. It's made in Indonesia. Okay, so it was made in Indonesia, meaning the clay. Probably some of the dyes might have come from Vietnam or China. They had to be shipped in. They used oil. I think Indonesia has oil, so they probably used oil. You can start seeing, it's a pretty interesting story actually, how anything is actually made. So the first step in a life cycle is to keep going all the way back. And it's fun to go all the way back, like this, this plastic straw, you're going all the way back to an oil well. Okay, somewhere in the world. Now it's a tiny little bit of oil that's being used. But this plastic straw, would make, from an industrial ecology, you'd have to think all the way back to the oil well. And all the different steps that thousands or billions of straws make. Then we have all the, as was said, we have the whole question of how is it used in real, how do you use it in the home, or how is it used here? And this hopefully, if I don't forget, will last a good long time and will be washed many times. It'll be used for many different drinks. So then there's all the energy of the drinks. A cup is not a static thing, it's used all the time. And then eventually it's going to break and get thrown away. And we've talked about how this might be disposed in many different ways. You could just end up, it actually might get thrown into the garbage. And believe it or not, this thing is going to go to the incinerator, which is just ridiculous because it's not going to burn. Nothing's going to happen. So we might think maybe it should go in a different way. Branford pays by the ton for stuff to go to the incinerator. So sending this to the incinerator, I'm going to send something to the incinerator. Branford's taxpayer is going to pay for it, but it's not going to burn. So it's not a waste of the taxpayer's dollars, if you will. So thinking of something from cradle to grave, that's called life cycle analysis. And then you have to look at the environmental impact of each step all the way along. So I don't know much about clay. Let's skip for a second to what's in my coffee cup, the coffee. Okay, does anybody know anything about growing coffee?
Can I go back a minute?
Yes,
what you
sure.
said about water.
Yes, good.
Does Branford have a recycling system for water? For watering yards, many people have a watering system in their yards. Having lived in Florida for a while, I'm familiar with that, where there is recycled water used for watering lawns, whether it be public or private.
So.